Have you ever wondered why you love something more when you are personally involved in building it? Whether it's making a house out of Lego or assembling furniture, the satisfaction you get by contributing to the creation process is unmatchable. But why does this happen? Well, this is exactly what the IKEA effect is. Wait, are we talking about that popular furniture brand IKEA? Yes, we are. Watch this video till the end, and we are sure that you will be stunned by this psychological trick known as the IKEA effect. The world's largest furniture seller, IKEA, is a Swedish company having 445 stores all across the world. In fact, it is so huge a furniture brand that it employs around 220,000 workers and generates a revenue of $40 billion. If you look at the top furniture brands across the world, you will see that IKEA is at the top with a revenue of $40 billion, and the second competitor to IKEA is Ashley Home Store, which is surprisingly not even close to one quarter of IKEA's. Now, what is so special about IKEA that it has made a $40 billion worth empire just by selling furniture? Why are people crazy about it? The answer to this question lies in one of the most beautiful business case studies that was done by Harvard Business Review, which dates back to the 1950s. So let us go to a little flashback. In the 1950s, in the American culture, mothers used to bake cake for their kids, considering it as their gesture of love and devotion towards their family. Now back then, cake making process was very troublesome, and it often took more than a day for the women to actually bake a cake. So there was a company called General Mills which came out with a fantastic idea to minimize the effort that mothers were putting in just baking a cake. The idea was something known as instant cake mix, wherein they gave all the required ingredients in a packet and the only thing required to do was mix those in a bowl of water and put that batter inside the oven. Within a few hours, you have your cake ready. Now imagine how great an idea this was that minimized the efforts of women to such a large extent that a process which earlier took more than a day was now done away within very few hours. On top of this, the cakes tasted delicious and the quality was never a problem. You must be thinking that this is one of the best products a mother could ask for, but well, contrary to your expectations, the product failed miserably in the market. Now the question is, what could go wrong with such a perfect product that minimizes time and effort, and at the same time, gives amazing results? Some psychologists were hired by the General Mills company to figure out the answer to this question, and as it turns out, there was nothing bad in the product. The only problem was that mothers back then considered this cake mix as an insult to their efforts, and they somehow believed that merely by using cake mix, they were deceiving their family. By using a shortcut, which even though minimized their effort, they did not get the same satisfaction that they derived from baking the cake on their own, which was more a sign of love and affection than just something to seek comfort. Effort, here, is not a problem but rather the ingredient itself. In this real-life example, the psychologists of General Mills understood a very important lesson in human psychology. They learned that no matter how inefficient the system is, no matter how tedious the work is, and no matter how bad the product is, if a person has actually put efforts to bring that output, that person will have an extraordinary sense of value towards that product. For the rest of us, it might be a stupid product, but for that person who has actually created it, the product will hold immense value. And that is how they concluded that labor leads to love. This is exactly what the IKEA effect talks about. If you look at the supply chain of any furniture company, what they do is the furniture first gets manufactured, it is then assembled at the very same location and then shipped to the retailer. Further, the retailer stores it in a warehouse and when a customer purchases the product, the retailer delivers the product to the customer's doorstep. Note that the furniture is fully assembled, as a result of which, it is delivered in large trucks. But you know what? That is not the case with IKEA. Well, the IKEA furniture is packed in such a way that it could literally fit inside your car. But how is that even possible? The reason behind this is that, unlike all other furniture, IKEA furniture does not come assembled. Yes, they come in pieces, and it is you who has to assemble the furniture at your home. Here's where the concept of DIY came into existence, that is, do it yourself. Just like mothers associated the value of their cake with the efforts they put into baking it, similarly, people started to develop a beautiful relationship and an extraordinary sense of value towards their IKEA furniture for the only reason that it was created by them. Now, people, this IKEA effect turned out to be super cost-effective for the company, saving them a lot of money which would otherwise be spent on logistics. But how? Ideally, in case of assembled furniture, you can't put more than one sofa in a mini truck because if you put one on top of another, you would be at a risk of damage to the furniture. So the truck occupancy was low, which resulted in large expenditures on logistics. But, interestingly, in case of IKEA, the furniture could be comfortably placed on top of another, as they were packed in small lots, which further resulted in greater truck occupancy. As you would expect, this saved hefty amounts for the company. Moreover, the money saving doesn't end here. Think of those retailers who had to spend so much on warehousing wherein they kept assembled sofas one beside the other, with the limitation that you again can't put one furniture on top of the other. Now think of those retailers who could easily get rid of large warehousing costs simply because they don't require so much space as they could easily place small lots of furniture on top of one another. And, people, that is how the supply chain turned so efficient and the cost reduced to such a large extent that IKEA was able to provide premium furniture at a very low cost. This led to the golden recipe of IKEA, which was to provide low-price, high-value products to its customers. That was all about the IKEA effect for you. Do like, share, comment, and subscribe to our channel, Explified.